It was a two-character drama. It was a love story, and it was semi-autobiographical, but and it involved a Marine during the Vietnam War in Okinawa. And there was also this young woman that the Marine fell in love with. The reviews came out, and they were wonderful. Linda did not review, and I should point that out. But there was one male critic who departed from the rest. And what he said just floored me. He said the play was very unrealistic because Okinawan women are not that pretty. And it just blew me away. I couldn't believe that would be written and, you know, that he could get away with that. So I was so furious, and I needed to vent. And somehow, I had always admired Linda. I didn't know her at all. She didn't know me at all, but I loved her writing, and I thought if anybody could commiserate with me on this, it would be Linda Weiner. So I wrote to her. I sent her a copy of the review, and I said, "Could you please write something about this in your column?" Well, to my great surprise, Linda wrote back to me right away, and I don't know if you remember this, but she said, I sympathize with you on this, but I choose not to get into a pissing match with another critic." And obviously, that was the wise thing to say. You know, we critics are not in the business of criticizing each other, although some of us would like to. But that episode spoke volumes about this wonderful woman because she's very thoughtful and she's very principled. And besides being an excellent critic, she is a wonderful soul. And I have to point that out because oftentimes those two are mutually exclusive, particularly in our business. Some have talent, some have heart, but not always at the same time. She merges the two of them. Now, I don't know if all of you folks are aware of this, but she made a very bold move last year. She decided to leave Newsday, where she had worked as the chief theater critic for 30 years. But it also meant she was walking away from a lifetime career as a professional theater critic that spanned 48 years. You look at her, that seems hard to believe, doesn't it? She defined a theatrical standard for many generations. And you should also know that she championed and made a point of championing women, great women artists. And I would particularly say playwrights, directors, and designers. So it's a loss that we don't have this voice anymore. But her departure, I would have to say, I regard it as a personal protest against the dumbing down encroachment of social media on our profession. Criticism is really kind of sadly turned into a free-for-all where every voice is equally valid that you see on the internet or hear, whatever, on the internet. And the more steady voices are drowned out by all that cyber noise. Linda put it best. She said, "You critics are reduced to click chasers." Did I say that correctly? Click chasers. And she's absolutely right. It's not about how many people agree with you or whatever. It's about a studied judgment about a particular piece of work, and we need more of that, not less. So I don't know where all of this trend.